Our names are Kaylee and Nate, and we've been friends with Jen for over 10 years.
We're just kidding, we're not doing the speech like that.
So we wanted to start off actually on a bad note, so it's really only uphill from here. So in all seriousness, I'm Kaylee and this is our friend Nate, and we actually have known Jen for over 10 years now, and we're honored to be her maid and man of honor. When Nate and I were deciding whether or not to make the speech a funny one or a serious one, we reflected on our friendship with Jen and decided to go with funny because 99% of our friendship has been the three of us laughing together. John's hair is actually gray because of all of the late nights that we spent laughing down in his living room. More specifically, Nate's laugh.
Yeah. I'm going to take over from here. Thanks a lot for that, Kaylee. This is probably hard for all of you to believe, but Kaylee and I were voted most dramatic and class gossip in high school. So if you can imagine, Jen has had her hands full throughout these years of friendship. But as we were looking back, we were thinking about the memories that we've had together. One that came to mind was a time that we went to a fire in the middle of the woods. And by that I mean, when I say we, it's actually just me and Kaylee. And it was because that night Jen was unavailable to tell us no, that this is not a good idea, and that we should probably cuddle in bed instead. And looking back at it, she probably was completely right, because we ended up running away from the cops that night and getting cut by old barbed wire. Promptly after we left that, we ended up calling the one person who has always guided us and never judged us for these poor decisions and lack of self-control, Jen.
Reminiscing on this friendship and looking back at all the memories together, there's no doubt that these last 10 years have been nothing but great. But when we think back to the hard times during this friendship, when we were all going through, tough things, either together or separately, those less fun times were really great as well. They were great because we always had Jen supporting us through them. Not many people are fortunate enough to have someone who is so supportive and understanding. Jen knows just what to do and to say to make you feel like you matter and that you were important to her.
Not only is Jen incredibly caring, but she has the ability to make you feel more motivated than anyone else can. She is, in a way, the athlete, the coach, and also the cheerleader on the sidelines. And I say this because she stays with you on the journey. She coaches you when you need it, and she's on the sidelines cheering you on when you need it the most.
Now, to redirect the attention a little bit, Scott, they always joke about not marrying into a family that runs 5Ks on holidays. But at least we'll give you something to look forward to when the Bills are out of playoff contention. Sorry, Scott.
We'd like to end by thanking Jen and Scott for allowing us to live out our dreams as talk show hosts and trusting us with a microphone in front of your closest friends and family. We love you both so much, and we truly can't wait to celebrate tonight and dance with you guys. And can everyone raise a glass to Jen and Scott?
Jen, from the moment we started talking during freshman orientation, I knew we would be instant friends. What I didn't know was that that day I made a lifelong friend.
Oh. Dear Jen, I cannot believe it's already your wedding day. I'm so happy for you and Scott and your future together. You have always been so welcoming when I first started dating Stefan, and I love when we get to hang out. Okay. love that you're not that into skiing, so I don't
feel pressure. Yeah. Maybe you're just skiing.
Scott is obviously the luckiest man in the world, but I'm going to claim to be the luckiest sister-in-law. I could have never asked for anyone better in my life to look up to than you.
Jen, there's no one else that I would rather get into a car accident with on the way to La Crosse. No one else I would keep driving to visit after watching a family of dogs get run over and crying on the side of the road. And truly, no one else I'd rather stand next to on their big day. You've been the best friend to grow with, and I am so excited to be on this journey with you and Scott.
Don't you do this to me.
The story that we always say that when we met each other was the first day of cross country before school even started. And you say that I was just like outgoing and like adopted you into like just like being my friend. However, I see it much differently. I see it as someone like you were someone who I felt so comfortable being with as someone who is like kind of an outsider at times in their life. So you were just someone who I felt like a comfort with. And so you didn't just like adopt, I didn't adopt you. Like you adopted me and helped me feel comfortable. In a hard, like it's a tough time. Thank you.
This is probably a good time then to tell everybody that I actually wrote Scott's vows for him. That's not true. Everybody did a great job. I did not do that. We've all waited over 2 years for this night, but the truth is I've actually waited a lot longer than that. I've waited a lot longer because I've hoped for a long time that Scott would ask me to be his best man, and part of the reason is because Scott is so reticent to put himself in the spotlight. And tonight, he has no choice but to sit right here while I have a microphone and all of his friends and family are gathered and we get to celebrate him together. And Scott's always been a great little brother. I always knew he wouldn't be a little brother for very long. It was a dead giveaway when before elementary school, Scott would down a dozen pancakes and a half a gallon of milk while I ate a normal person's breakfast, that the size advantage wouldn't last for very long. I did take advantage while I had it. We used to play floor hockey, which meant Scott put pillows on his arms and his legs and I would hit slap shots at him for an hour. And we used to play buzzer beaters on the rim in our backyard, which meant I got the chuck shots while Scott rebounded for me and I dreamt of glory. But really it meant that Scott did it with a smile on his face every single time in typical Scott fashion. But those of us that got the chance to play sports with Scott knew that he wasn't always the soft-spoken little brother. Sports brought out that edge in him. He was a little bit more confident, a little bit more assertive, a little bit more of a go-getter. And I remember when he left for college that I hoped that college would bring that side out of him a little bit more, that maybe that competitive spirit would come into his everyday life and he would turn from that soft-spoken little brother to a more confident person and that person that we, self-assured man that we knew him to be. And to my surprise, it worked. That summer, he came home and he had transformed. He was confident, he was beaming every single day, and he was a new man. And it turns out it wasn't just the magic of a liberal arts education that had transformed him. It was Jen. Jen, you're a confident, strong, smart person, and you have always brought out the best in my little brother. That much was obvious from that first summer that he came home from college. You have also single-handedly guaranteed that I will no longer hold the physical advantage over my brother at any time throughout our lives. CrossFit is not in my future. Neither of you are the same people that you were in college. In fact, our hangovers tomorrow will determine that none of us are the same people that we were in college. But it's been incredible watching the two of you grow together through thick, through thin, through questions, through changes, and everything that life has thrown at you. You're special people, and together you're unstoppable. I know neither of you love being the center of attention, so again, I want to thank you for giving me this opportunity to celebrate both of you tonight. So let's raise our glasses and do exactly that. Let's celebrate this happy couple. Cheers to Scott and Jen. We love you both.
Thank you everyone for being here on this great day. Today we get to celebrate the marriage of Jen and Scott. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Stefan, Jen's oldest brother. It's quite an experience for me to be up here right now officiating my sister's wedding, but I'm honored that you both let me do this, and it makes it a lot easier knowing that my sister is marrying a genuinely great guy like Scott. Today we get to celebrate not only your marriage and future together, but we both have already. So to start off, I'd like to share some of their story with everyone. There were a few different events that had to come together for Jen and Scott to meet. Both attended Siena College. Siena was Scott's first choice, and he got in through early action, and after that, it was a done deal. But Jen was a little different. She admits that she wasn't even really interested at Siena at first, but luckily was dragged to campus through a tour with her parents. Her attitude completely changed on that tour, and it was eventually the school she chose. In their first semester there, they ended up in the same elective class, but it wasn't until the Hawaiian Christmas-themed rugby party that they first really met. Now, both Jen and Scott played sports growing up, but I don't think anyone from either family could have predicted that they would meet their future spouse at a rugby party. Scott had never played rugby at that point, but joined the team. And luckily, Jen's brother Jay and I were hard enough on her growing up that she was tough enough to play as well. They dated through all 4 years at Siena, and after college, moved in together, and they began their family with the addition of their cat Zena, and eventually Piper. After settling down in Albany, they chose to start the adventure of hiking the Adirondack 46ers, a collection of all the Adirondack high peaks, which is where another chapter of their life would begin. One weekend in June, their plan was to bag two more peaks, Mount Porter and Cascade. The day before their hike, Jen was wavering on whether or not they should even go and texted Scott saying, "Do we still want to do this hike tomorrow?" Scott responded with a simple yes. At the top of Cascade is where Scott proposed, and he even found another couple at the summit to capture it. And then here we are. There's been a lot that's transpired in the world since then, but we made it to this day.
Jen, when I started thinking about what I wanted to say to you today, I quickly realized that, probably for the first time in my life, I was going to have too much to say. I fell for the trap of trying to write the perfect vows, when all I really want to tell you is how much I love you, and everything that you mean to me. I feel overwhelmingly lucky to be standing beside you today and every day. In you, I find a level of comfort and stability that could only be my wife. It's just something about that smile that gives me butterflies every time. You see things in me that I have trouble seeing in myself sometimes, and that feeling gives me all of the courage I could ever need. How could I not have fallen in love with you? You accept me for all that I am and all that I'm not.
and it's impossible to ignore the remarkable impact you've had on my life. I would also like to say from experience, everyone should find someone smarter than them and make sure they never leave. Jen, you are driven, determined, compassionate, and sensitive. You're my best friend, my biggest supporter. Because words simply cannot do it, I will show you for the rest of my life just how much I love you. Jen, I promise to always see you the way that I see you today, and to always make you feel as loved as you make me feel. I promise to always give more than I take. I promise to encourage your beautifully imperfect dance moves. And for both of our sakes, to always get you food whenever you get hungry. I promise to always take you on our annual apple picking trip, as long as you help me try to read each historical marker we pass along the way. I'll never stop trying to make you laugh, even though it's remarkably easy, as we've already seen. I promise to always give you the best of myself, and to love, respect, and trust you, as I know that we will build a life far better together than either of us could ever imagine alone. And now that I've made these promises to you, I'd like to tell you what I want from our marriage. I want all of it, hand in hand and moment by moment. I want to start every day for the rest of my life with you by my side. I want to be the man that you deserve and the man that my parents so lovingly raised. I want to clear the snow off your car and wake you up with a cup of coffee before you even realize I was gone. I want to coach the soccer teams and wait for the school bus. I want to and will love you with every ounce of my being for the rest of my life. That I promised you. I love you, Jen. Can't kiss.
I knew that was gonna happen.
Eager beaver.
Scott, while today is a dream come true, it is not something that I dreamed of as a girl. Growing up, I didn't spend time imagining my fairy tale love story or the day that I'd marry the man of my dreams. That said, I made up for lost time over the past 9 years. So now that we're here, officially locking it down, I feel it is safe for me to admit that even on that very first night that we met, there was something unusually comfortable about being around you. From there, falling in love with you was completely effortless and admittedly fast. It wasn't long before with you is where I wanted to be and where I still want to be always. With you is where I feel most myself, carefree, and calm. It is where I feel most free to dream big, chase goals, celebrate success, and welcome failure. Through incredible amounts of change, you have been my constant. Through every adventure, you have stood behind me, encouraging my self-discovery and ready to keep loving me no matter what I find. At the end of each day, your arms have been open, reminding me that I am never alone and am always overwhelmingly loved. Beyond that, there is so much I love about you. I love your smile, your empathy for others, and your genuineness. I love laughing with you so much, and I secretly love that you challenge my competitive side, even when it means that our shared hatred for losing clashes. I love the sides of you that not many others get to see, the loud, goofy, strong-minded, and vulnerable ones, the curious one that desires to know what every historical marker says, and the destination of every plane that passes above us. And while I love sharing our biggest adventures together, the best times are truly the simple ones, like movie nights in your five-star living room forts or sunny day drives to anywhere. I love that you're always up to create fun with me, and I promise to always be here ready to find fun with you. I promise to support and encourage you when you take your own risks. I promise to respect your own passions and prioritize our needs equally. I promise to communicate and collaborate, to hear, acknowledge, and respect your own point of view when ours differ. I promise to have faith in our ability to move through all of life's obstacles together. I promise to always prioritize the health of our marriage through every phase of our lives, and to never lose sight of how lucky I am to be the one that gets to love you. Love you.
Really good.
Hi, Scott.
Hi, Scott.
Take you, Jen.
Take you, Jen.
As my wife with this ring.
As my wife with this ring.
Let it always be a symbol.
Let it always be a symbol.
Of my undying love for you.
Of my undying love for you.
And Jen, please repeat after me. I, Jennifer.
I, Jennifer.
Give you, Scott.
give you, Scott.
This ring.
This ring.
As an eternal symbol.
As an eternal symbol.
Of my love and commitment to you.
Of my love and commitment to you.
And by the authority vested in me by the state of New York, it is my honor to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss. It's my honor to introduce, for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Scott and Jennifer Fuller.
So, does everybody have a drink? Okay, settle in, because I'm going to tell you about my wonderful daughter. From a very young age, I always knew that Jen was going to grow up to be a very strong woman. At about age 3 or 4, when she was in preschool and her older brother Jay was in about first grade, Jen was home at the end of the day, and Jay gets off of the bus after a hard day at the office. And he comes into the house, and Jen is standing at the refrigerator getting a glass of water. And he decided he wanted a glass of water too. So he, being the big brother, walks up and just kind of bumps into Jen to get her out of the way. She looks at Jay, looks at her glass of water, and throws the glass of water into his face. Jen wasn't taking it from anybody. I've also known that she would grow up to be an exceptionally loving woman. At age 12, Jen got a horse. Zeus. Zeus is a wonderful animal, still. But he threw her several times in the first few weeks that she had him. But she never gave up on Zeus. She would go to the barn and spend hours sitting in the stall with Zeus, talking to him. And eventually they became stuck together. They formed a mutual trust and love. And that is something that Jen has carried with her ever since and will into the future. So, Scott, let me start by telling you all what I don't like about this guy. All right? There's a few things here we have to work on. All right? Your blind allegiance to that baseball team down in New York. Hey, it's Red Sox Nation, buddy. All right? I'm not going to knock you too bad for your allegiance to the Bills. But it's also a Patriots nation. But seriously, you know, of all of the amazing qualities that Scott possesses, the one that I value most is his ability to make Jen smile. your kind-heartedness, your warmth, your graciousness, and your love are some of the amazing blessings that you have received from your wonderful family. Today, you married Jen, but Nancy and I, the boys, feel that you've been a part of our family for many years. Everybody has a drink. I'd like to propose. I don't know what the future holds for the two of you. I know that 20 years from now, many things will have happened that we cannot predict. But whatever happens, wherever you go, your family you know will always have you. You'll have each other's love, and you'll always have ours. So may your love be modern enough to survive the times and old-fashioned enough to last forever. Cheers.
Demand has really been amazing, frankly. I mean, I felt this groundswell of support from the back all the way up, so. Let me just say this. You know what? You two, well, let me start with Scott. I've known him a long time. I mean, we're like that. People said he looked like me. And you know what? I think he probably does, but 99% of him is like Laura. What a gift. What a freaking gift. Yeah. And I think he's growing out of the former. So, you know, we'll see how that goes. But when the first couple of times we met Jen, not exactly, but one, she was playing rugby. And then another time down the road, she was doing CrossFit tournament at Utica College. She scares me, frankly. So Jen, whatever you want, whatever you need. But you know what, Scott and Jen, I do have an admonition for you, and that is, look around here. There are a lot of people who have done this well. There are a lot of really good families, good marriages here, husbands and wives. I'm blessed to know so many of them, and you were born into them. Frankly, that's just luck. But you know what? We made it by hard work. It's none of it's necessarily easy, but it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be joyous. You share the fact you both have big hearts. My God, Scott, you bring food, good food to people who don't have it. And Jen helps good people get healthier and live longer. I mean, how good is that? So, so John and Nancy, we are proud to have our families merged. There are great members of our family here. Throughout, I hope all of you shake as many hands and meet as many people as possible, because we all read too much and listen to too much news. There are lots of great Americans here. Amen.